Welcome everybody here to game number two of your grand final of the EIZO Cup, where RoXKIS is going up against iCCup to see who can take out our fourth installment here of the EIZO Cup. Let's jump ourselves inside the draft to get this party started, and the man who's partying with me the entire night long is my co-commentator. He is known as the Capitalist. Welcome to the broadcast.
Yeah, buddy. RoXKIS versus iCCup. Is it? How do you say their name?
iCCup.
iCCup. All right. Yeah. I just wanted to make sure. That's what I've been calling them, but
I used to actually get completely screwed with them, and it was one of those like autistic moments where you go iCCup. Yeah. when you start doing that, you realize you're in trouble. I realized a long time ago I was in trouble. So RoXKIS, Dire side, iCCup will be on the Radiant side. And we're starting off our draft, taking out the Magnus, so he won't appear in this one. At the same time, Resolution. I'm wondering if he's tossing up right now if he wants to ban out the Batrider. Because he's taking some time to decide this. The normal ban will be the Batrider, but that means he's got to give BZZ the Lifestealer. And he takes out the Gyro and says, let's play ball.
I think that's the smartest ban he could have. They can either get Lifestealer and RoXKIS will have the Batrider, which is a bit of a counter to Lifestealer, but it's still manageable. Either way, it's still manageable. And the fact that they have the second pick allows them to take advantage of this. Now they can pick pretty much any support hero that they want to go with Lifestealer, or they can pick some sort of really strong offlane. They have a lot of options available to them, and Batrider is not the worst thing in the world to deal with.
Yeah, there could be worse things. Keeper of the Light and the Nakes would be worse things.
There it is. I mean, that's their combo. It's going to be a really aggressive tri lane if they want to, mm-hmm. or defensive tri lane that nobody wants to deal with that's also going to get more farm.
Ooh. I'm really surprised that from RoXKIS that they went with the Darkseer and the Luna this early on. And the reason why I'm so surprised is, again, we have this kind of scenario where you get a long laner in two roles. You got both Batrider and the Darkseer. So it's Batrider in the solo mid now. I mean, it's very, very obvious to Resolution, but they don't pick up the Bane. They don't pick up direct counters towards the Lifestealer, which means if iCCup really want to do it right now, like, what have you got? You got Lasso. It's the only primary thing that's going to stop the Nakes from doing his thing. And even then, it's not going to be enough time and control to hold him there. I'm very, very much surprised at this. It might also be a precautionary pickup because they're fearing what's going to happen if the PL is picked up by iCCup right now. That could be our other thing.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's much more of a defensive draft rather than the aggressive shutting down the initial hero that you see on the block. That's the power of Lifestealer. He's still really effective no matter what sort of counters you get against him, and he doesn't have to be the hard carry. So you're absolutely right in that regard. They could pick up a Phantom Lancer either now or if he lasts through the banning phase sometime later in the draft. Luna is a good counter to both of those heroes. Darkseer is a very defensive counter to Lifestealer. Really good by himself, Lifestealer. That disable versus Darkseer. Serious Surge, you know, it's pretty much mute. Luna, when it comes to carry potential, is with equal farm, can take out a Lifestealer. Mm-hmm. When you have that Manta, you have that Butterfly, you're able to put out a lot more damage than Lifestealer. And if they do pick up a Phantom Lancer, which doesn't look like it's going to be the case, Luna still does well versus Phantom Lancer. Not harder, but you have timing where you're a stronger hero and you can take down towers and force racks before PL gets too big.
Yeah. But that's, yeah, the timing. You're right, it'll be right for RoXKIS. I don't know if Resolution wants to go down that path, though. When there's just so much against it and you're not 100% sure if you do get your timing right, and you probably want to be looking for someone else for that Lifestealer to really couple with, even though now he's got a Puck and he can jump himself around like that one. Yeah, that was something else I was thinking of. If Nature's Prophet becomes their third core hero in this to allow them to run their aggressive tri-lane, I'm still waiting for that ban of Bane from Resolution. It hasn't come out just yet. And he actually bans out the SD to start with. Man, this really is looking like a PL. It really is looking like it. I'm wondering if BZZ will just ban it so he doesn't have to deal with it, or if he feels there is enough confidence in his lineup that he can deal with it.
You know, if Phantom Lancer is banned out, there's no reason why iCCup can't pick up the Bane themselves. They do have the first pick coming out of this banning phase. Or actually, I'm wrong. Never mind. RoXKIS actually has it. So I'm actually a little bit surprised because Bane would work well. He's a good counter to Lifestealer, but it would have worked well in iCCup as well as a kind of a counter to Batrider in the same sort of regards as Shadow Demon.
And it was so obvious, though, that RoXKIS would take in the fourth selection. So Visage comes off from IC Cup. Or maybe this is the thing where Resolution knew without picking up Bane, which means we got ourselves, I'm not going to even say a slightly passive support hero, because Bane is a pain in the ass to bring down. Once his nuke gets up a little bit higher, you've got this huge amount of life steal that even like Visage tries to nuke him out, and Bane like, I take my life back, straight out of you. Not a problem at all. All they need right now is like a Lina or Lashrak or a Jakiro on this top lane to babysit that Luna. Or they say, screw it, let's go aggressive tri-lane. I see couples like they want to go aggressive tri-lane right now and be very, very successful at doing so. Luna slightly cut out of position. Will actually happen because of open wounds, and will happen because Visage will also have his Grave Chill. Doesn't even need the massive burst damage at the start. Just buy some time to slow down Luna, let Nace get some right clicks in, and then Keep of the Light with one blast. Level 2 hits on that top lane. You don't want to be there as a Luna. You just don't want any part of it. To a point where you're just abandoned when it happens.
They completely countered him. And the fact that in the laning phase, they're going to absolutely destroy RoXKIS. RoXKIS, if I have to rate supports, tri-lane versus tri-lane, Bane is one of the last supports I really want to have. Versus an aggressive tri-lane, heavy damage dealers like this, Bane, you have to play really, really well to be effective. You have to hit the perfect nightmares, dodging the Caudal Blast or those sort of things. And that's going to be up to him as a player whether or not he can do it, but he's at a significant disadvantage to really be effective in this lane. So RoXKIS has to think long and hard about really what they want to do here. They could potentially bring in a jungler, play very, very passive, have Batrider be a jungler and pick up another mid. That way they have that experience advantage, so they play really passive in their dual lane, have Batrider come in when he has that experience and that level advantage to try and gank. But iCCup is just going to run all over RoXKIS no matter what they pick up here. So because Lifestealer in lane versus a Bane isn't that good, if you have the advantage where it's you're not looking at kills constantly, you can keep Lifestealer from being able to pick up CS. But when it comes to kills, Lifestealer with Rage, he instantly takes away the sleep from allies. He can run, just pretty much run at them, and there's not much Bane can do. So Chen is going to be the answer. So they are going to pick up a jungle. I was expecting one of their current heroes to be a jungler, but they pick up an extra one.
I wasn't expecting Chen. I was actually going through the mindset of BZZ right now, which would have been, okay, if our top lane's not going to work, let's go for income. That'll be the mindset that would change. Chen, however, being the pickup, I'm really not sure about, because I said it, because Chen has one creep in the early stages of the game. We'll let him gank a little bit earlier on, but if early game is what you're thinking about, then Enchantress would have been a better selection, or an Enigma. And I say Enigma, not because, like, obviously Malifaux, you can't use it on the Nakes, but because you can get an army of conversions up and running, and those guys do a lot of damage. And here it's like Keeper of the Light and Visage are not going to have a great time against Enigma. They get Malifaux up, they get caught out of position, you have Bane as well. Chen, it's like all they want him for is a troll creep. That's the only thing they're really searching for out of him, to hold that Lifestealer back. But Keeper of the Light as well as Visage can move quite nicely into the dire jungle and slow down that farm of Chen to a point where it'll become a real, real frustration. And RoXKIS, like, what are they going to do? They're going to run Darkseer on a long lane, so Resolution just needs to pick up a hero now and go up against that Darkseer. And he might even just leave Lifestealer down there. Juggernaut's the pickup. Juggernaut can also do very, very well up against the Darkseer. So I see no problem with this lineup at all for IC Cup, but I definitely have question marks about how successful that jungle of RoXKIS is going to be.
Yeah, I do believe that RoXKIS got outdrafted here. I think IC Cup has a much stronger team. But that being said, if RoXKIS can make things work for them for the first 20 to 25 minutes, if they can just survive and do well, they have a significant chance to be able to take some Outer Tier 1 towers, get in some gold on Luna. She's going to be the harder carry here, especially with Darkseer and Bane on the back of them. Very strong heroes going into the late game, even Batrider with that really good disable. If they can just survive, do decently well in the laning phase, that way they have a chance in the mid game and take this late, I think they're looking pretty good, but it's going to be really tough surviving through this laning phase for them.
Yeah. Let's see how they go, man. There was a quick pause up here from IC Cup because some of the players were taking a while before they chose their heroes, but everyone's in now, so quickly before the players get out of their lines. There's even swapping. I don't know if you saw that. Vanskill's like, whoa, what's the reason? Really? No. Technical problems. So IC Cup, I don't know if you just saw that, but Mag actually picked up the Lifestealer. And when they got into the game, they switched the heroes around. So Mag is now sitting up on the Juggernaut, Jackal is on the Lifestealer, Fly is on the Keeper of the Light, Resolution on the Puck, and puts Weegee Stick on his Visage. And then through the RoXKIS lineup, Yol supporting as the very, very Turbany Chen. We'll have Solo as the Batrider. Dread gets to take his signature role as the Darkseer, and that was BZZ, Hard Farming Luna, and our final one, Vanskor, as the Bane. And I want to see if there's going to be... There's not another... No, they're not changing up. Mag is actually... Again, they're switching the lanes. Mag is heading towards middle lane, and he's prepping for a bottle mid. So we're going to have Magnus in the middle lane up against the Batrider, which kind of surprises me a little bit here.
They might just be completely trying to dodge RoXKIS. Because if I was RoXKIS, I would try and put, because of the fact that Juggernaut does well versus a Darkseer, just with that healing ward, he can survive in lane long enough. And once he hits level 6, it's actually a bit of a danger for Darkseer because he can't rely on Surge just to get away. So I would be trying to put the Darkseer up against the puck. In middle, Darkseer does decently well. We used to see him in middle versus like dual lanes, the Wisp CK and that sort of thing. But against squishy heroes like Puck, where you can maintain some room control, he's going to do decently well and try and put the Batrider up against the Juggernaut. That would be my plan. I don't know if iCCup is doing one of those sort of things where, oh, they're going to try and do this to counter us. They're going to move these lanes over here, so we're going to, you know, counter that counter or that sort of thing. Or if they just feel that this is just better for them. But Darkseer against bottom, against Puck, that's a really hard lane for Puck.
Yeah.
So that turns out to be the lanes. RoXKIS is going to win their bottom lane at the very least. Middle should be a bit of a draw just because Spin and Healing Ward, Batrider can't do much to kill him. He might be able to get some rune control in and gank top, though. That's the biggest thing, is if he, once he hits level 6, you're going to see him putting some pressure on the tri lane.
Lanes are moving.
Oh, this is smart. I like this.
So BZZ will take the Luna towards the middle lane, and we'll have Batrider Solo will go the long lane, and that puts Vanskor putting a very, very timely ward watching the tri lane for iCCup head top lane, but it's the Bane up here and a Darkseer, and now I think they've realized the problem. There's a haste rune up on Jackal. If he comes up and finds this Darkseer, then I don't see Dread surviving this. He went Iron Shell first level, and they would have seen that when they went past him. But the lane's now become a little bit more interesting. BZZ should have a little bit more fun here in the middle lane. He's already one for one here in the middle lane up against Mag. But Darkseer with Iron Shells. Nakes doesn't want to get in close on this. It's already a double, it's a double Iron Shell on this top lane. Pushes out a hell of a long way. Visage feels useless because now they can't gank up on one here. They don't know where this Chen is. But Chen's already here. May as well pop off that smoke with Vanskor. And they're going to see if they can gank up the middle lane. And Weegee Stick comes in just at the right time to help out against BZZ. Just his presence here is going to help this gank to be evaded. And if Weegee Stick goes down first instead of Mag, it's a better thing. Yep, the central just got revealed out of smoke. Because that observer wall was up on the high ground. Gank fail.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate. They needed to do this. RoXKIS, I like the fact they switched up their lanes, put their Darkseer up against that. That's really, really smart. Luna will do well in middle. The biggest thing about this is when you draft and you end up having lanes that really almost
fly.
Everyone should lose.
Jackal, Dredd's baiting. He just stayed out that fast. They would bait a little bit further. So Nightmare, Centaur's coming up for the stun, and Fly takes a lot of damage from this one. He's still going to be able to walk himself away. Centaur, no body blocked up very, very nicely there from Yol. Jackal even going to open wounds and try and stop this surge, getting body blocked up by the rest of the lineup that's there from RoXKIS. But Yol still managed to slip through the cracks, and on bottom lane, Sol's got to kill on Resolution. Firefly it up and just walked over the top, and now RoXKIS get a kill on both of their lanes. Top and bottom. While BZZ might get harassed back in the middle lane, it's a small price to pay.
This is one of the best ways to counter if you have the drafting phase and you end up kind of losing the draft when it comes to laning phase, and you're going to lose potentially 2 out of 3, maybe even 3 out of 3 of your lanes. Confusion is the best way to deal with that. A lot of smoking, moving around, ganking by the support, switching up your lanes like this. This is wonderful. I mean, they did a really good job. They've established 2 early kills. I was talking about surviving the laning phase. Right now, they're winning it. Mm-hmm. So this is really well done by RoXKIS. If they can keep this going, maybe cut down on the aggression a little bit. Bane right now is just jungling with the Chen. That's a really smart idea. As long as they keep up and don't feed many kills, they're going to be in a really good position.
Yeah, that they will be, man. That they will be. But they still also, at the same time, need to control Jackal a little bit more on the top lane. If you check through the net worth, even with all the first bloods and everything, the top net worth belongs to the Batrider. Solo got that solo kill on the bottom lane. He's had a solo lane down there. So he's been feeling really good about himself. But the middle lane, it's basically neck and neck between the Juggernaut as well as BZZ. And that's why there's another hero in that middle lane helping him out. But on the top lane, it's a 1,400 net worth up on Jackal. He's still looking better as far as that income goes. His gold per minute is above that of the Darkseer, who is trying to catch up, but is still about 20 points behind. Top tower is under attack.
One of the biggest advantages of Vistage is when you level him with, like, put him with a, like, Keeper of the Light.
Jackal has walked down here with no boots whatsoever underneath the Dire Observer ward to come into the middle lane, and it's a tag team with Mag. It's a tag team with Mag. They could have just left Visage to be there. They both switched over their lanes, but no. So Jackal is now going to go middle lane with We Just Six supporting him. And BZZ says, well, okay, you want to lose him? Let's have a crack at this one, but maybe not. That's a big nuke. BZZ, huge overconfidence, giving now a kill to the Visage.
Yeah, that was... I mean, that rotation was a lot of wasted time there, potentially, for iCCup, but they just made it worth it by giving away that kill. So, BZZ with a bit of a misplay there. Meanwhile, bottom, Yol, I was expecting him to go into the enemy jungle eventually, and that's exactly what he's going to do. Now that this dual lane, he might have a chance to kill the Keeper of the Light.
Maybe. He needs a little bit of help. Chen coming in from the side with a nuke would do the job. Four on the stacks and the Chen nuke. One more attack. It's not going to be enough. 33 life points, and Resolution actually gets the revenge kill. The Centaur stop will slow him down, but he's got another orb in 1 second time, and Yol, he actually stopped moving so he can micro with Centaur, which means orb and right-click attack. Resolution just follows up with the kills in the bottom lane. So RoXKIS's advantage they had from their nice little maneuvering around early stages, not working out so nicely, and we just sick. He's got a nuke up his sleeve. Vanskull wants to dive this one down. Jackal's already taken too much damage. He has to retreat. And BZZ, are they going to try and dive We Just Sick here? One loosened beam is still enough. He hides in the tree line. TP support's got to come in, and it's here from Resolution. If he throws out the ult, he can hold them both here. There's already the Grave Shield going on BZZ. Jaunt, not going to come. He's just happy for the fact that We Just Sick gets to live through this one. You see BZZ turn around. We Just Sick was waiting for the right time to get out here. Puck throws the ulti down. There's an extra TP coming in from the Lifestealer now. And Resolution, he's got Rift. He's got... Oh, wow. He didn't actually phase shift out this one. He didn't wait. I mean, he waited too long. So Jackal trying to attack, and Vanskor, nice body block here, keeping Jackal away from BZZ, which means now they can turn around and fight on him. They need another loosened beam. Not going to come. Yol, he had vision, but he didn't throw the nuke out, and Jackal probably realized it wouldn't be enough damage to get a kill. And they fall back 3-3. We've got ourselves another pause game coming up from We Just Sick.
Yeah, this is the beauty of this kind of game is Dota has always been a game of mistakes, right? There's five people on a team, and that's just too many, you know, factors to really keep account of to play a perfect game. And it gets even worse when you see a confusing game like this where the lanes are not what you expect. People are switching up their lanes left and right. You've got supports moving all over the map. And both teams are making a lot of mistakes. I mean, that bottom lane, Batrider giving up the double kill because he went in on Keeper of the Light too early. Chen was not in a position to finish him off real quick. Those sort of things, I mean, this is a back and forth. You're going to see a lot more action, I feel, from this. And all around should be a really exciting game right now. RoXKIS is in a slight lead, but sending about 900 gold. The experience is pretty minimal, one way or the other.
Mm-hmm. And it's some fun times. But of course, you know what happens when you're in a pause? You got a moment to actually tell people about what's going on after this grand final game. If you do wish to kick my ass, go to facebook.com/EIZO Cup and sign yourself up. The 1v1 challenge will be coming up after this. It's a new thing we're trialing here for all those people that wish to cause me some pain in a 1v1 solo mid. If you win, you actually win yourself one of the Forces FS2333 monitors. So, yeah, beat me, win a monitor. If not, we give you a consolation prize, like Dota 2, the board game, so you can keep on playing it time and time again and remember what happened in the middle lane. Yep.
Oh, man. And there are a lot of people out there who want to cause you pain, Toby.
Yeah. You're one of them, Capitalist. You're one of them.
Oh, I know.
Because I know the way it works, man. I know the way it works. Like, are you going to stay up and watch G1 League? Oh, I was going to fall asleep and just wake up for the Alliance game. Do you want to stay up and watch G1 League? Okay, let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. And all of a sudden, how is that burning in the back of your eyes? No, that's actually burning farming in front of my eyes.
Oh, yeah. G1 was... Yeah. Times.
And then it was a no, I'm not spoiling it. I'm not spoiling it. For all those people out there that keep on looking at it, our editorial boys have been doing a really fantastic job of doing recaps of the days of play. So you guys should really check it out. They're really nice and detailed. If you don't want to like load up the live stream or find a VOD or do things like that, and you just want to catch up with what happened, they're really, really nicely detailed and come with screenshots and all that kind of jazz. So yeah, and no spoilers on the news articles. We actually haven't had spoilers on our news articles for about 3 months now. And it's been nicely received, so we keep doing it this way. Obviously, things like Mini and Select going out of QPAD Red Pandas, that's more of a title than a spoiler. So yeah. But check out the recaps. They're really cool. And we know because a lot of people are reading them. Like, a lot of people.
Yeah, I have to say, I'm one of them. Whenever I'm working a late shift or something and I can't watch those games, I'm on my phone pretty much 24/7 when I'm at work trying to look for something to do. And those are godsend. I can keep up with Dota 2 and you know, have that still on my mind, as it always is, 24/7, and still be able to keep up the scene while working.
is how I started my day, man. I woke up, it's like, you know what, let's have a sit on the crapper, and just go, okay, matches of the day, reading through on my phone, oh, Light of Heaven's going to be casting TI3, oh, interesting situation there, and G1 League Playoffs recap, game by game. It was, it's the best way to wake up in the morning, man. It's the best way to wake up in the morning if you miss any of the games. It's nice. It's nice.
And you want a good way to go through pauses? Mm-hmm. Just entranced. Being entranced by the life stealer his portrait.
What? No, not the jaw. It's lockjaw. It's lockjaw.
Just bouncing up and down.
I still can't help but think that he's like... Like, life stealer has got to be English. But it's because and the funny thing is, I actually feel like I'm not anywhere near as bad as Lifestealer. But my top row of teeth were actually really nicely done. Had like the braces and not the full braces. Had like a plate and stuff to reposition them so they look really, really nice. But my bottom teeth they were stubborn. They were so stubborn they wouldn't change. And when we got them close to what they should be, another tooth came up and said, yeah, screw you all, I'm going to bump you all off to the side. So I kind of feel, hence I can say it too, because I'm also half English, I can say, yep, top half of my teeth Australian, bottom half of my teeth English. It's just the way it works, man. And Lifestealer, I'm pretty sure, he's just like me, man. He's just like me. Except without, the skin, falling off and blood trickling down from the teeth. That's not cool. That's obviously, definitely gum disease.
Squinty yellow eyes, everything. Yeah. No, but by the way, did you figure out the rules for your 1v1 later?
I've been told I will get given the person I'm going to be fighting up against. Moosman's going to give me his details at the end of this game. And then we join a game and we play it out. There was actually rules over on the page itself. But I was also a little bit confused by the rule where the two hero. Like, you would get your choice from the hero. It doesn't make 100% of sense. So, Moosman, I know you're tuning in right now. Please make it make sense.
Here's the thing. This was just in the chat, so, you know, I can't really... But, you know, it's your mods. They're trustworthy, right? They said it's basically there are going to be two random heroes, right? And the opposing force gets to pick first, right? The random guy. He gets to pick whatever hero he wants first, and you get the other hero. So this could be really, really bad for you, potentially. Granted, there could be, you know, perfectly fine random, you know, classic solo mids or something like that. Or you could be, say, an Earthshaker versus a Viper. Just saying, that might happen.
I would just summon the spirit of Dendi and just, like, dominate with that Earthshaker. 100% gonna happen.
That being said, that's a good thing, though, isn't it, Toby? I mean, at least you could be like, oh, the matchup. The matchup was shite.
Yeah.
You can't do anything about that.
I got a reason for failing. I wanted him to win a monitor.
It's not SF 1v1 mid, you know? It's not a mid that's based solely on last hitting skills and that sort of thing. It's just you know, Earthshaker versus Viper. What can you do about that? Nobody can win that.
No, at least you
might have an excuse.
It's like, I will sacrifice myself. I will sacrifice myself for the greater glory so that one of my viewers out there that wants to cause me harm gets to win a free monitor from iZo.
Question is, Toby.
Gotta take it for the team, man. Gotta take it for the team.
What if you get someone who's like, who really mans up? Who's like, Earthshaker and Viper is in the pool, and he's like, yeah, I'm gonna beat Toby with Earthshaker. And then you have the nervous of, oh, I can't lose this.
And if I lose it, man, it'll be the Prophet TPing in the middle of bloody Creek Wave all over again. You know it's gonna happen. You know it's gonna happen. There's just no way avoiding it. It's going to be death. It's going to be a very, very shameful death. And there is nothing that can be done about it. But for all those people who have now tuned us after Starlighter has ended for the evening, greetings. If you don't know what we're talking about, go to facebook.com/iZoCup and sign yourself up. You have a chance to face me in a 1v1 at the conclusion of this grand final, and the winner wins one of the FS 2333s, the iZo monitor. So you get yourself a free monitor if you beat me. We are currently sitting here paused in game number 2, as it seems like Keeper of the Light is having some extended issues. Hopefully, we get him back inside the game. Right now, iCCup are one game up. Kind of felt like we're already heading into a game number 3 at the start of this game, considering RoXKIS. Like, their confusing start did wonders for them. And then Luna died in the mid. And then Resolution got a double kill on the bottom lane. And then life didn't seem to be as good. Life seemed to be a lot harder for RoXKIS.
Yeah. Now, they got that early lead, but kind of threw it away. I mean, these are one of those just really crazy games where mistakes are going to happen because it's not traditional laning Dota. So many weird things are happening in this game. You're so distracted trying to keep track of what heroes are where, you know, if you're going to be ganked, what's happening. Mistakes are bound to happen. So it's one of those messy games of Dota that sometimes are really fun to watch.
Yeah. I like watching those messy kind of things, man. But I also like watching the precise things. And because if you want to watch the precise things, remember what iZo Cup. They're actually a company called iZo. Not Cup at the end. But iZo have sponsored the defense. Coming up on Wednesday night, we start the group stages of the defense. Scheduling for that one should be coming out on Monday. So if you want to know what matches are coming up this week, it's going to get pretty intense. EMS starts their next cup on Monday and Tuesday. So tomorrow, as well as the day after, we'll be covering EMS on this live stream. Probably a little bit of Starlighter here and there in the middle of it all. I try and cast as much of that as possible, but obviously not always possible. But the defense is really going to like clog up the schedule. We're going to have games going non-stop, man. Absolutely non-stop. Just a look at the schedule. We actually start at 18 CEST on the Wednesday and Thursday, obviously, so we don't clash with the Eastern qualifiers coverage, which will be going until about 18 CEST. So we start off with Group A and Group B, and then around Wednesday, Thursday, and then on Friday we actually start earlier in the day at 16 CEST, and that'll happen the same starting time for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So huge nights of Dota coming off from the defense. This stream is going to be going non-stop for the next 3-4 weeks until there is travel for a LAN event. But yeah, EMS as well as the defense, we're basically going to be tag teaming these guys all the way through, and even getting ourselves into the point where we'll have like tiebreaker matches. The entire group stage is over and finished and done and dusted by the 13th of June.
I'm not gonna lie. I know why Holy Master said that. It just looks really funny. Stop talking in Russian.
It's frustrating as hell, though. Like, when you're an admin in there, like, it was happening before in one of our previous games, and, like, this guy is talking Russian in all chat, and it's one of the, like, co-casters of Leodonna, and I'm like, yo, dude, like, don't talk. I don't know what you're talking about. You could be like giving away secrets. Would you mind just shutting up? That'll be fantastic. Thanks, dude. Beautiful. Let's move on. And looks like we might get to move on. Oof. Keeper of the Light back inside the game. So Seems like he is Julius. Julius Caesarus? What? Olive?
Well, now it's English, but it still doesn't make sense.
All right. All right. We're back inside the game. We're launched again. So after our filler material, hope you had a great time. We're back here in the game. 5 minutes in. 5 minutes in.
Gotta love those 15-minute games where only 5 minutes has progressed. But Solo has picked up a double damage and is sacking Ancient, so that's gonna be really helpful for RoXKIS later on. I'm interested to see. I mean, I don't think he should be going this. He's not getting nearly the same amount of farm as the Luna from last game. But Helmet Dominator, you might see it on Luna, but I don't expect it this game. I expect a much more aggressive Naked Yasha into BKB just to be able to deal with this early aggression that you know iCCup is going to be putting out in that 20-minute mark.
Mm-hmm. I like Mag's little move here over to the side. Just spin it up and take care of the Iron Shell creep. Just takes away from that easy farm that Dread was trying to pick off on the side camp. Would have also frustrated the Juggernaut if he ever tried to pull in through the side. Was this moving from Solo? I noticed too that Solo was babysitting that regeneration rune. He had multiple questions about if he should be picking this thing up or not, because he already had a DD rune in him. And now he's going to trigger that one off. And you're seeing Resolution just hiding. He doesn't want to be on this bottom lane, but BZZ doesn't want to be in the mid. Nightmare, they're going to get this Nightmare off him, and they're successful. Keep it alive, throws out a very big nuke, and now they move over towards Vanskor, and we just think he's got a nuke again. That's Vanskor, so actually no brain sap. Nice timing. It was the only thing that would have saved him. The only thing that would have saved him. But Luna is still dead again.
Mitigating the damage as much as possible. Solo, he's really doing the smart thing. When you see like offlane Darkseers and they go behind the tower and they pull the creeps to the neutral so they can get extra CS, that's basically essentially what Solo's doing. He's farming up the lane, he pushes Resolution out, and when the lane isn't where he wants to be in the tower or anything like that, he goes and he farms up the jungle a little bit.
We just sick just popped level 6. Add familiars now to your calculation of the team fight.
Ugh.
Or even just ganking. Just ganking is enough to make you just say, something could be changing here. Solo
have
is...
we seen Have we seen Nake's visage bombs?
Nope.
He can infest familiars, right?
I believe so.
I'm sure he can infest.
They're gonna go on BZZ right now. He's thinking about popping up the eclipse. While familiars are here, it's not gonna be anywhere near as effective. And Vanskor comes in, tries to nuke down Wee just sick. Also not effective. Nightmare up on the Lifestealer. And then Solo, for some reason, attacks him, so takes the Nightmare off, and then Vanskor says, no, I want to have the Nightmare. And then Mag says, I'll make a Nightmare, and just jumps himself in towards the middle lane. He's got ulti too. If he gets vision on Solo, he'll just jump, but Puck actually comes in from the side Resolution. Throw out the ulti on Solo. He'll throw it, and now Juggernaut can bounce. Solo's being sent back to base. Juggernaut should not bounce on this one, even though he did. That was really dangerous. Because he had the possibility of bouncing and then just following the dead corpse back to the base. But a 7-for-3, and iCCup coming force. All 5 players now here in the mid. At the same time, Dread's trying to take out the tier 1 tower on the top lane. But it's still a trade, however you look at it. Tier 1 for a tier 1, and a whole bunch of heroes from RoXKIS dead.
Yeah. I mean, I wasn't feeling the greatest about iCCup, the fact they gave up early kills, but that gank was just really well timed. Again, 5-man Dota from iCCup. They just keep on doing this. They want to be able to win all of their lanes, and then they play 5-man Dota after that. And
Fly
just
might be in trouble here. Solo, maybe not. Open Wounds goes out in Solo. Yes, Firefly will basically just hit one patch in that middle lane. I thought for a moment when Keeper of the Line, he got knocked down into this small little gap in the where the weeds are in the river. Well, he might actually get himself completely caught out, but I guess they couldn't capitalize. They still don't have these big abilities like Vanskor. He's level 6, how long is this going to take? Chen didn't have a Hand of God for the rest of his team just yet. Solo threw off a lasso, but for very little reward. And BZZ, he could never do his ultimate when you got familiars and you got also all of iCCup that's just hanging around. Who are you going to kill? Nakes doesn't even care. Mag won't care. They both are like immune. It's like, you want to throw it down? That's still magical damage from the eclipse.
iCCup has really impressed me this tournament with the way that they are countering the enemy team's strategy. They always have the timing down really well, and I'm expecting to see the same thing. Once you start to see that Batrider get close to Blink Dagger, Bane has his ultimate, those sort of great solo pickoff abilities. I'm guessing iCCup is going to be grouping up as a five-man crew like they tend to do so, and that's going to work really well for them. RoXKIS has a lot of pickoff, and that'll allow Luna to keep farming, but if they stay as a five-man, they push down these towers, there's nothing Luna can really do.
Attempted denial on the mid-tower, not going to happen. Visage gets the last hit, fake Luna's coming in, trying to bait out some attack damage, but of course iCCup already knew that illusion room was there. I don't know if you've been seeing the small little battle happening on bottom lane. Resolution versus the Batrider. Batrider keeps coming in, being so aggressive, saying, I have Lasso up, I want to kill you, and Resolution just hangs back past the tower. He is not taking any risks on this long lane. While Solo is able to just control up his entire jungle, and Resolution's getting very, very little farm.
Yeah. Yeah, while Resolution is getting denied some, occasionally Batrider's getting extra experience and gold from that jungle. So he's really going to come out on top. He has his Blink Dagger now, but I don't know if RoXKIS really want to be grouped up right now.
Is he wanting to? He wants to. Spin and the Fiend's Grip. It goes off from Vanskull, but it's doing no damage to Mag because he got into that spin before Vanskull triggered it off. Familiars get the extra stuns. So RoXKIS lose two in the middle. Park ulti, the timing was right. Even if Batrider does have his Blink Dagger, he's back at base. He wasn't even involved in that. And lost Darkseer and Bane because of it.
Yeah. It was, it's no surprise that they lost that fight. I'm not sure why RoXKIS felt they needed to group up and five-man push. I mean, if they could take down a Tier 1 tower, that's great, but they really have to wait for Batrider to pick somebody off, somebody really important, before they can even attempt to do so. And even then, if it isn't the Keeper of Light, it's going to be a really hard time pushing in. So, all around, I think they just need to focus on their own form, maybe get some really defensive wards up, and try and get that Yasha BKB up on Luna. And at that point, they do have some team fight, but it's going to be a long ways away.
Well, Solo, Vanskull, they're trying to force it earlier. Blink, Lasso, found Ouija Stick. Familiars might be able to buy him a little bit of space to get around this, though. Ouija Stick's got a lot of damage, which he can throw out. Nightmare, get it taken off. Can he throw this nuke out in Solo? No, he can't. He actually dies to the Firefly at the end of the day. These Familiars keep chasing it. Mag, ulti, you know he wants to. Solo's Firefly just ran out, but they're looking for Vanskull. Puck, Jaunt, now look for the Puck ulti. Vanskull and Dread both caught in it. Vanskull will take the stun, but Jackal coming up behind it. Dread also takes the stun. Extra silence, there is no surge that will save him from this one. And Juggernaut ensures the kill with the Omni Slash. And it goes 10 for 4 now, up on the board. And I think that was also full drums that was just purchased. It's a Robin Magi and a wand for Jackal.
That's what I'm talking about. That was a really good response by iCCup. They turned that, little pickoff by RoXKIS into their advantage, grabbing the Darkseer in exchange for the Visage. Definitely worth it. And they got close to picking up, extra heroes on top of that. So, well done by them. They're buying room for the Luna to farm, but Luna has to get a lot of farm before she's really going to be effective. Meanwhile, iCCup's going to be taking out Tier 1 towers.
They get rid of the healing ward. That's kind of what all that just equated to. That whole jump just equated to killing off a healing ward. Firefly was down and didn't have a lasso. Familiar, well, actually, two of them gets picked off. Nice little aggression. While Jackal, and this is also another reason why I wasn't quite sure about picking up a Chen. So I thought they might even try and go for an Enigma. It's because Jackal can just infest up on the big creeps. You just saw him there in the middle lane. Like, Yol's there with like a three creep army, and all of a sudden it's two creeps. And if there was a hand of Midas build up on that live steal, there'll be less creeps. Bottom lane, Dre's in trouble. Blinding Light forces him back. Familiars won't be able to get the stun off on this one. They're trying to do a lot of damage while Solo. He's got Blink Dagger Lasso. Ouija Stick wasn't opening. Fiend's Grip also available right now. Puck will throw an orb, damaging down Dread as he pops the mech, so still more damage than that. And that mech charge actually healed. And Firefly's wearing off for Solo.
Yeah, they really shouldn't force the fight here. I mean, they're not going to get the opportunity to have the pickoff. Luna's pushing in top. In exchange for Juggernaut pushing in middle, that's worth it to them.
Yeah. As long as Juggernaut can just TP top lane and hold the Lunar out anyway. There's a TP coming from Puck, in fact. So it's Resolution that has to hold him out in the top lane. One fight for every bit of the gold. How's Lunar looking for items? Like you said, Yasha and then BKB. Right now, we're 15 minutes in with Treads and 1300. That's really not that great. In fact, her net worth is like smack bang in the middle. She's 6th highest on the net worth graph.
That's no real surprise. I mean, middle Luna is okay versus certain heroes, but then you have a dual lane versus that. There's no way. So she had a really hard time picking up CS. A lot of deaths. 3 deaths already. Only 1 assist. So she hasn't really participated much in these team fights, picking up any sort of kill or assist gold there. Mm-hmm. She is really hurting for farm. And you're going to see Juggernaut with this gold that they're going to be getting from these towers. You're going to see Juggernaut be able to build an early Aghanim's. That's what I'm expecting from them. And even when you have BKB up on Luna and a little bit of damage from that Yasha, Juggernaut with Aghanim's Omni Slash is still going to be able to pick her off if he has a little bit of room. Mm-hmm. So
picking her off now is a bit of a catch-22 because the Aegis Immortal is now on Luna. So yeah, with Roshan going the way of RoXKIS because that's that extra gold and experience too, or who's being brought down the bottom lane. They want to fight. Resolution is a Blink Dagger, which RoXKIS don't know about. He bought it up from the side shop and then TP'd down. So we'll see if there is initiation, but it's not coming from RoXKIS. RoXKIS, it's almost like they're just happy with what they got and said, okay, let's not count too many chickens before they hatch. Let's just get ourselves back into our lanes, find our farm. Middle lane's pushing out nicely. It's going to do some damage to that tier 1 tower unless someone comes to stop it. And maybe that's what they're also counting on. Solo's moving up. There's no new warning up from iCCup. They're actually completely blind on the map. And they're just going to 5-man. They're 5-man Dota bottom lane. Tier 1 and Tier 2 tower. If they lose their Tier 1 tower in the mid, they're looking for a trade-off. There's no fortification for RoxKiss. And now already a TP in towards middle lane. They're looking for no trade. They want to take this. Oh, there's a jump out. Fanscore's dead instantly. Hand of God tries to keep him alive. A losing beam on resolution means he's going to phase shift out to add this damage. Throws up the orb. So they manage to trigger up the Aegis the Immortal. We just sick, brings his familiars up. One storm, first hit, doesn't hit. Second hit does. Centaur's also being slowed down. And now, Puck was picked up there by Solo. Back in again. We just sick, he's got a huge soul assumption that he can throw out right now. And he wants some extra space, and he's not going to get it. Mag being in, actually, Fiend's Crypt up. Vanscore, now he's fighting up against familiars. Mech Charge again, really saving their asses here. Dread, while Jackal is searching for a kill. Not to do some good armor toggling off here, while familiars try and help him off. Rages is already enfeebled, so very, very low on the damage. Solo's right behind him, a flame break. He'll use it to push him back down again. And now Keeper Light try and pull him out. It's not going to work. Omni Knight does come in, spins up. No one else is near Solo right now, so if he wants to, he can throw out the ultimate. But always want to fly. Blinding Light forces Solo back again. Mag, not while the Centaurs are there. He won't do it. But this is a lot better fight for RoXKIS. They just chased down these kills one after the other, and they just picked off another familiar too.
Yeah, that was really good. I mean, finally, the gold lead had actually jumped up a little bit in their favor. It's now dipping back down. That was a really good fight for them all around. Trading towers like that was huge. Just by itself. I mean, they forced iCCup to group up as a 5-man crew and then completely dodged it. iCCup had to teleport in just to be able to force that fight. I mean, the Lifestealer was sitting in that puck for so long, expecting some big fight at bottom, expecting some big defense where they could, you know, really just take it to RoXKIS, and they weren't even there. So instead, they had to respond with teleports and still lost the fight.
Mm-hmm. That's like the worst possible scenario that iCCup could have properly thought up. And now another problem is with Luna pushing out that bottom lane. TP, Park jumps in. That's what you were saying again. Destroying the Luna. They won't be able to deny off this bottom tower, but they won't care about it. Solo is flying around inside of Invis, but it's 5-man Dota all over again. Familiars will come in. Solo's got an option if he wants to kill this thing. It's worth it. So he'll take the familiar. It gets picked off, which means there's no familiars for this fight from We Just Sick. He's basically a walking nuke. As long as he's still got the mana pool to support that. That was his problem in middle lane. He ran out of mana, basically. And Solo, oh man. 4-star for Puck chases him. Let's off the silence of the Hand of God. Already has to pop prematurely to make sure that Solo... Oh, Juggernaut! He jumps with the soul assumption. The spin is on the Fiend script. They've got to support him off. Jackal's on his way in. He wants to focus on Vanscore. Mag gets some extra space. Now Jackal getting nuked up. Dread getting nuked as well. Nice back in again from Dread. The Keeper of the Light blast. It's really hard there on Dread, but the Nightmare's on We Just Sick. He'll throw another nuke out on Vanscore, who doesn't have enough to repair that. And a big blink in from Resolution. Needs one more hit on Vanscore and gets it as well. Phase shifts out a lot of the damage. And they want to keep chasing. Yol's trying to send back as many players as possible before he's going to get spun up and dead. And iCCup even coming in range of that tier 3 tower. The healing ward brings it back up to full life again. And then we'll take out this tier 2 tower on the bottom lane. Now it's iCCup that are one after the other picking off RoXKIS. Oh, attempted denial. That is not what they want to do. What they do want to do is a back into a wall with four heroes. But instantly resolution too far away. Another spin coming up from Mag and RoXKIS. Even with Dread's Great Wall, they just don't have the support to do that. And Resolution chases the kill. He blinks and gets it. Lasso out from solo. I don't know if Resolution can get himself away from this one. An orb phase shift, not fast enough. The brain sap came out. So there was no retreat for him at the end of the day. But the rest of iCCup will retreat. They take towers, they take kills.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to get another pickup here and always want to fly. But that's the best they could hope for when you saw that team fight happen, right? And really, iCCup, they kind of overextend themselves. First of all, with the Juggernaut Omni Slash, putting himself on a really bad side over that cliff right next to the Bane. Juggernaut and Lifestealer both almost died. That was a really bad position for them. And then again, the secondary fight where they had a five-man wall vacuum combo, and they still couldn't do anything. And that just goes to show RoXKIS' lack of team fight and the overwhelming power of iCCup's team fight.
Mm-hmm. And now we ask ourselves, where do we go from here, man? 21-30 in, iCCup, they're taking fights, they're looking good. RoXKIS, though, like if they had that combo all work at the same time, it could have been a very, very different style of engagement. So you kind of wonder, like, where is our next step? Like, Lifestealer, we see him getting bigger and bigger, doing a lot of damage during the fight. Park, his next step is Sheepstick. So we see the Alban Orb coming up from him. He's looking for a way just to shut down that Batrider or the Luna. And Luna, like, is that a BKB coming out to her? No.
No.
This Luna's got nothing.
Yeah, Helmet Dominator was a very risky pick and item choice, and it's not paying off. It could have gotten a lot worse. iCCup, they could have taken away the Ancient stack that's already there. They blocked it, first of all, which is really well done by them, identifying the fact that Helmet Dominator means Ancient stacking is
trouble.
Going on.
That's Solo's caught out. Jackal get a couple of hits, and what a time for the Firefly to wear off. Chen was trying to pull him back out again, but that's an expensive death. A gem now going the way of always want to fly because Batrider dropped it. A very, very expensive death.
All these little things are just making the Golden Lead just drastically jump up in the Radiant's favor. I mean, the Ancient stack, not being able to stack that, not being able to... I mean, he could go and pop it at any point. I'm sure they realize the ward's there by now. The attempt to stack hasn't worked the last couple times they tried for it. So it does look like he's going to do that. That's going to make up a little bit, but it could be so much better. And this Helmet Dominator is not paying out so far.
No. He's got to get to that BKB, but then again, we're going to go to the other point of the fight saying, well, you got BKB, but Nakes is still going to eat you alive. There's nowhere to really evade that. And iCCup say, well, you're already on the bottom lane. Sure, you're going to get a stack, but we'll take your T1 tower. And with all five heroes in the top lane right now for iCCup, they can force that tier 2 tower out. That's the option they have right now. And with the healing ward of level 4 behind them and a full set of two familiars up and running, of course they want to do it. Mag wants the money. He is so close to his Aghanim Scepter he could smell it. It's 200 or so gold away.
And this is really the advantage of Juggernaut. He forces this very, very early advantage. So Lifestealer, he doesn't, until he has Basher and some attack speed, even AC, he can't really shut down Luna really hard. Juggernaut's gonna be able to do that with his Aghanims.
Both of them have to drop already. Just setting the creep wave out a little bit here. That's Soul Assumption out into solo. Not really that much damage. Familiars actually going to get themselves away here because RoXKIS still want to fight this. Mag, he's got ultimate up and running. He wants to use it. A quick napalm's not going to change much. And Luna, she is back in this fight because she got brought in straight. Like, she TP'd onto that tower. She had to use two bottle charges already. In fact, now just use the third one too. That's flying the courier out. And iCCup, they bail.
Well, they force RoXKIS to group up. They're just going to go back to farming. They almost have that Aghanims up on Juggernaut. He's almost level 16 as well, sitting at level 14. I'm not sure if they want to wait until he's level 16, but at very least, the Aghanims is going to be a big advantage, taking out that Luna, and that's going to give him a significant advantage until Lifestealer hits his next big items.
The thing they might have also been waiting for is the fact that Keeper of the Light can now afford a mech. So the mech, the mech is up 25 minutes in. Blink up from Park through the ult. He actually airballed it out. Thought he got Yol, but it didn't really work out that way. And now Yol wants to run away. There's a Firefly. Lasso onto Jackal. And Jackal with the double damage. No one wants to stay around that one. Aghanim Scepter jump. It was just a normal jump there from Mag. Didn't able to get himself a kill, and then the Eclipse goes off from BZZ. Man, this fight is absolutely crazy. The wall goes down, and then it's going to be a quick blink himself away. Yep, up to the high ground. Resolution's away to safety. The wall's gone down. Nakes Coddle for the price of a Chen. That just got very, very scattered very, very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
It's like the fight went in three different directions. Wall, what? Roshan timing.
Wow.
It is the only reason for this. It is the Roshan timing. That's a very clear that's a very clear message to RoXKIS. Don't you even attempt it.
They have a lot of disposable income too. So I mean it just goes to show think about Luna attempting to buy back right now. It's just you wouldn't even imagine it. She needs that gold so badly. Well, this lifestealer, he bought back and bought a Skull Basher at the same time. So, the pickoff there of the Batrider being able to pull Lifestealer in a really bad position, followed up by a Bane, easy Bane ultimate, that's a nice little combo, because normally a lot of times Bane ultimate, it's easily disrupted because you're in a bad position. With the Batrider, it's wonderful. You just put him in where no ally is possibly anywhere near, and you just absolutely take out that hero. So the pickoff worked well there because of the confusion. I'm not sure if it's going to work again.
There's going to be confusion in a moment. If Resolution wants to blink himself in, orb up, he's got a jaunt, throws down the orb, and now comes Nakes. BZZ's the main target, and he got stunned up, but Chen, wonderful pullout. Wonderful, wonderful pullout. That's all Assumption was going towards him and would have ended up killing off that Luna. And now, though, Ross gets a split out. Solo has to Firefly himself out of this mess. And they realize with the Chen down, maybe they won't think about going in. Oh, Flame Break, really nice. We just 6 caught. He needs help. We need to cut him out of here. He's got to TP himself. Dread's going to come in and see if he can cancel it with the back, though. Actually, cleans up the tree line. Also brings in Jackal a lot closer towards him. And they look for blood off that one. It still achieves the same thing iCCup were looking for, and that's the Visage getting free of this. But Smoke, Dread, oh wow, not Smoke, just an orb and then a jaunt, and Dread's actually far enough away. And Dana Courage not doing enough damage, keeping the light blast. Solo has actually got himself caught now. Blink Dagger on cooldown, 4-staff on cooldown. But at the same time, I don't know if you've been watching that top lane, but the tier 2 tower's been taken out. Another Flame Break, bumps we just sick up, there's a lasso on him. Pucky faced you because he thought it was going out in him, and then the Eclipse from BZZ. A quick soul assumption out into Solo, and then Oh, wow. Juggernaut throws it out. Even with the Hand of God, it's not enough. Resolution gets Fiend Script up. They need some kind of cancel here on Vanskor. Jackal just walks straight towards him with the spin damage. He gets a bash out in him, and a nice crit from Mag allows him to get support for support here. Blinding Light, Solo still wants back in on this one. Always want to fly, just keeping his main boys alive, the damage dealers. Because there goes the Chen down for another time. Solo blinks into that small little narrow path on the side so he can keep attacking on Always Wanna Fly, who does go down. Infest out from Jackal. A lot of damage on the Vanskor, but now Nightmared up. He gets himself away, though. Raging and walking. He's got support. Mag coming in. He'll just spin up on Dread and TP out on top of him. Wow, is he looking to go for this one? Dread has a BKB popping it off. It doesn't stop the Juggernaut from getting away. Back out again. Remember the Armlet toggle. He's got no Infest possibility, rages, but that Napalm stays with him as well as the Enfeeble. He can't turn and fight this one, and now the Troll coming in. He's looking for a body block. He's like, fuck it, I'll just like attack the Troll, and he actually gets some decent life out of that one. He's trying to Armlet Toggle up, 5 one charges there. Solo 4-staffed in with the Iron Shield damage. Impossible to Armlet Toggle on that one, but Dread's going to lose his life. They chase so far down for that one, and now Mag wants another kill. 26 seconds till his ultimate. He can't catch it to Vanskor, can he? No, he cannot. I think we can call an end to that engagement on the bottom.
Yeah, that was a really long, drawn-out engagement, and that's the advantage of RoXKIS. I mean, they did a really well job. Finally, they forced a fight, picking off that Visage. It didn't really work as well. I think they just wanted to grab the Visage, but iCCup, they fully forced that one. So in the end, I would call that result. They lost a little bit more than they were hoping to. They really delayed iCCup. The Roshan still isn't down. It gave them a lot of time. Like you said, the tier 2 at top went down. They did a little bit of damage to the tier 3 just purely through the creeps as well. The longer this game goes, the more it's in favor of RoXKIS, and that actually gives them enough time to get BKB on Luna.
Mm-hmm. Well, she does have now, but also bought out for it. So if she dies inside of that BKB, life is not going to be great for him. With a Juggernaut, with an Aghanim Scepter ultimate, it's going to be very easy to actually kill her off inside that BKB. Well, after the BKB's gone, sorry. And just look for all these extra supports, because that jump is never going to end. Heroes like Chen have got to make sure that he has an army at all times. if possible, skeleton minions, and Resolution's already on the hunt. Haste, Rune, and Smoke, and they got Yolt. No way, really. Open wounds, open wounds, open wounds. There we go. Hand of God. They're deep inside the base here, but an extra bash from Jackal ensures the kill. We just sick throws out a quick soul assumption over to BZZ. But this should be the tier 2 tower now down. He threw the Hand of God to try to stay alive in that one. It's not as though he has an Aghanim Scepter completed yet. He actually went Aghanim Scepter straight away because Darkseer went the mech.
Yeah.
But he hasn't got there yet. He's about 500 gold away from it. And then they can add the 32nd Hand of God. And we saw how long and drawn out that fight was.
Mm-hmm.
It'll be worth it once he gets it.
You know, that pickoff is okay. But the amount of time it took for them, they used Haste, they used Enfest, they used everything like that. It's still slightly in the favor of RoXKIS just because they can farm everywhere else and they're just delaying. Finally, it seems like iCCup, they're a little bit more focused now. They need to take out some of these tier 2 towers. Just focus on taking out the towers. They can easily get that. Oh, bottom.
Oh, they find two. Bottom lane's being pushed, but Vanskor gets stunned off by that ultimate from Resolution. And Jackal actually getting bumped down a little bit there by their Flamebreak again, causing so many issues during teamfights. Yol, he's the main target. There was already that first little hit, and he actually gets a second bash out here. Jackal, the wall might be down by Dread, and that's causing some issues. But then Jackal, he actually gets lassoed and dragged back in range to the tier 3 tower. Infest will save his life while Juggernaut kills off the Luna on the other side of the wall. And when is this Nace going to pop out? Now he pops out. Dread, he actually was a little bit too close there. Took a decent chunk of damage, and RoXKIS lose three, and this opens up the pit.
You know, honestly, I feel that RoXKIS, if they had had the support there for Luna, when they were all chasing her up and going to the Secret Shop, and she had that cliff advantage right there, if she had popped BKB, fought it with the Helm of Dominator, I really think she could have output a lot more damage, and they could have potentially won that team fight. But she just didn't feel like she had the support of her teammates in time. And that means Roshan's going to be picked up. And they're probably going to see iCCup go ahead and take the tier 2 atop, push out some of these lanes, farm up the jungle a little bit, take tier 2, and then settle in for a nice base race. Or not base race, breaking the base. I'm all over the place.
I know what you're talking about, man.
Yeah.
I'm here for you, dude. I'm sure everyone in the chat's also. But I don't know who's going to really be here for RoXKIS when Mag binds up his next item. You see his cash he got off that last fight. He now has the highest net worth in 3.7k. Like, he's going to be a beast. He's going to be an absolute beast. And the fact that Jackal got those two bashes off as well, and first hit bashes. Like, Darkseer is going to be so annoyed at that. He got a really good wall off. And then the fight split in two because Jackal caused issues. Lastly, it had to be used on him. It's like, where do we go from here? All these massive abilities get thrown into the wind because a couple of extra bashes, and you get really frustrated because you get caught on the wrong side. And they know now, like in the next fight, you're going to have that in the back of your mind. Like, what happens if I get bashed? Especially when when Juggernaut buys a basher himself.
Easy kills. Easy kills coming up.
And the bash will the bash will transfer, won't it, during Omni Slash?
I believe so. Those little attacks that he gets in between Omni Slash when he has enough attack speed, it does end up working.
But the attack of the Omni Slash itself doesn't do that.
No. I don't believe so. I think it's just the attacks in between.
It
used to be that
sure
way in Dota 1, but they changed how Omni Slash worked.
Yeah, okay. It's probably the reason why I wasn't 100% sure about it. But hey, that's the reason why we confirm these things. iCCup, they're looking to break, man. They are looking to break. Scythe of Vice and Blink Dagger and Resolution. Mag says no, because he's going to basically push out this top lane a little bit more. And with that TP back, maybe they're feeling a little bit of intimidation and say, well, maybe we can go out now. iCCup, they fall back a little bit more, but Keep It Alive still got his ultimate up and running. And there's the recall. He's dragging him back. They pulled RoXKIS out of the base. They saw the Firefly over on the side, so they were surging for it. That's why the Keep It Alive Blast was heading over there. But iCCup are ready to go back in again now. They won't lose anything on the top. Blink Dagger now can't work for Resolution because the Flame Break. But they destroy that creep wave of RoXKIS so quickly.
No.
Solo's trying to keep that Blink Dagger of Resolution on cooldown as much as possible. But Resolution's ready to go in. They see Dread, Blink, Hex, and then Hand of God almost instantly pops off there. And there's your Juggernaut jump. There's no creep army here for Chen, which means it's a full set of jumps out from Mag. Spins, fence call will go down. There's a buyback from the Dire side, and it's going to be BZZ coming back, and the Agassi Mortal is going to trigger, but that's on the lifesteal. It's the only casualty of war for iCCup right now. Resolution, he's pretty close to being the secondary one, but he'll blink himself back in range of the tower and run a little bit further away. iCCup really diving for the monies. But they've also got a catapult coming in and a new creep wave. Keep it light blast, maybe a little bit too premature there. Should have been looking for the dire creep wave. And this one creep, which I think is actually controlled a little bit more, held the creep wave out long enough they could just focus on the tier 3 tower. Mag comes back in again. BZZ, open wounds, hand of God, Aegis, and the Aegis himself are working overtime right now. But the damage has already been done. Dread bashed up as well. He had both Mag and Jekyll next to him. There was definitely a high chance of a bash. And BZZ is going to happen again. Lunar Bolt back just to die again. Double kill for Jackal. Solo will take a fall on the tree line. And they'll move over the extra supports. Jackal, two hits, no bash. While Vanskull's on the run, keep the light blast going to hit, but there's the open wins. One more hit, there's your bash from Jackal. Second hit gets the kill. And they'll dive in on Vanskull. Decent nuke. But that is going to be GG well play coming off from RoXKIS. iCCup will be the victors of the EIZO Cup number 4. So we give them the congratulations as well as a large share of the prize money. 1,750 macaroons up for grabs. Courtesy of EIZO.
Well done all around. I mean, RoXKIS, they did what they could, especially that Chen. I mean, the reaction speed of teleporting that Luna away before she got killed by all of that burst when they initially jumped in, saved her life. Darkseer bought back as well, but it still was not enough. I mean, that's just the power of Juggernaut. If you're able to survive the team fight, you force out a lot of ultimates, especially with that Blade Fury being able to dodge a lot of magic damage. Then you healing ward afterwards. It's like a team fight happened. You're perfectly fine. You're ready to fight again, and the enemy team is just suffering. So really well done. I think it comes down to some really really good drafting by iCCup. I feel that was one of their biggest strengths here. Mm-hmm. I felt that they had sort of outdrafted RoXKIS both times.
Yeah, but as we said though, for RoXKIS in game number 2, they were really good with what they were doing. Like, they managed to mix it up. They managed to like just change it up a little bit. The strong draft of iCCup wasn't as strong as it could have been. This game could have been over a lot faster if iCCup got the lanes exactly the way they would have predicted it to be. But RoXKIS made him work for it. They made him work for it. And it looks like they're making him work for it a little bit longer as Yol is refusing to leave the game. He's microing up Solo back inside the base right now. Just having a little bit of fun with himself. So he's refusing to leave. And it looks like our admin for the night also doesn't have the command to give the victory to the Radiant side. So we'll end our game up right now, guys. But remember, of course, the winner... In fact, I will contact Mooseman right now to see who the winner is, who will face me in a 1v1 matchup. It's coming up right next, The winner will be announced. I believe the winner's actually already been contacted and will be waiting in a game, waiting for me to arrive. But yeah, you're having fun because there's nightmares going all through the pit and it's all being controlled up by y'all, aren't you?
No, I was actually laughing about the fact, Toby, do I get to in-game spectate?
Yes, you can in-game spectate.
Yes, I want to watch that.
I will also. I'll also be streaming it out from my point of view. Let's see how much an Omni Slash does to a Hand of God. And Mag's gonna go. Mag dies. 680 gold of his thrown away. What a waste. That was his second death. That was his second death in this game. Dire's middle tower is under attack. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Yul's ready. He killed the Juggernaut. Now he's pushing out as a 5-man crew.
He was the default win, man. He was the default win. RoXKIS already killed GG, so not gonna happen, man. Not gonna happen. Oh, and I actually have the winner of the competition. It's over on my side screen right now. So he has 5 minutes from the time the game is hosted up to connect into the game to play up against me. His name is Benedict Galerio. Benedict Galerio is the winner of the competition. So if he connects into the game, Benedict, we will see if you can beat me and win one of those EIZO Forus FS 2333 monitors. I'm interested to see how it's going to go down, man. So yeah, guys, stick around. Stick around after this matchup. It's not ending. Admin command.
Somebody say something. Yul's like, nope, I got this. Oh dear.
And he's using everybody bar himself to do it. His hero is halfway back down the middle lane.
He doesn't want any more deaths, you know.
Obviously.
He can make his allies look bad, but...
Don't sacrifice yourself at all.
While we're doing this,
uh-huh.
I'm gonna go ahead and well, before we lose everyone to your 1v1, all the viewers, my name is Capitalist, I'm not Merlini. There are still some questions. I love your chat though. I mean, it's not exactly the way I want to be known, but the very least, like, every single time I have ever casted for anybody or by myself or whatever, people, who is this caster? And I kind of make joke of it, you know. People like say, who are you exactly? I'm like, oh, I'm the hipster caster. You probably never heard of me, you know. But at the very least, your chat came up with a good way for people to know my name, and that's Kappa.
You're a capitalist.
Want to go?
You're a capitalist.
It's not the way I want to go, but at least there are less. Is this Merlini? Question mark. So
it could be worse, man. It could be worse. By the way,
exactly.
Y'all just lost his entire teammates inside the base. So there you go. GG, well played. So and we stay true to our motto. We stay to the end stat screen. That's the reason why we're still in the game. We stay to the end stat screen. And we should give ourselves a little bit of a wonderful last view, because if you double click on something, it won't pull your camera straight to the throne. So we'll get ourselves a very picturesque end. I like doing this. It's my thing. So I'm staying with the mega range creep that's bringing down the tier 4 tower. But yeah, stay tuned, guys. Also follow Capitalist. It's Dota Capitalist on Twitter. We didn't get him out last time. So we get him out this time. I realized too, it's not as picturesque because I was on a creep next to the fountain that actually went down. But yeah, follow Dota Capitalist. You can follow myself as well. You can follow myself, TobiWanDOTA, over on Twitter. We have ourselves great fun over there. Some days we just have the worst fun. I'm saying worst fun as a positive negative. But yeah, hopefully you'll stay around, guys. 1v1 matchup coming up soon. Capitalist, any last words to shout out to your peeps back at home?
Oh, yeah, I promised. Shout out to Chappie and shout out to the Big Bad Bird and Revolution. Those guys and that group, the guys that I've been doing my OMG times two only mid, that fun. So shout out to those guys.
Oh, fantastic, man. Fantastic. All right, guys, stay tuned. I'm about to get my ass kicked. Maybe. Stay tuned. We'll be back with our EIZO Cup challenge.